Alright, coming at you today to talk about carry bands. We offer these and we sell a lot of them. So, we put together a kit that actually will build this thing from the transfer case to the end of the carrier bearing in a kit form. Comes with a couple of different components, but it does come loose like this. This right here is your mount that will mount to the chassis side, and then you can trim this thing off anywhere you want to. This will end up welding right to the carrier bearing housing itself. I'll kind of explain how to do that and make sure that it's right. And you've got a yoke goes with this. It's kind of a little bit of a press slip-on fit. And then I sell a piece of tube that whenever you go online, you can order this in whatever length you want to do it for your carrier bearing. We'll send it to you. So it's a really simple setup that we've kind of perfected around here, but we've perfected it to where I can put it in a box, ship it to anybody at home. But then I always get the question of how do I get it trued up, and then how do I figure out where my mount goes and the angle that this mount goes at on here, you know, how's that happen? So there's a lot of questions that come with this, and I can answer all of them pretty simple, honestly, by just kind of showing you step by step on how it goes into the buggy. And if I can just move from the table to there, it just kind of helps out a little bit. So we'll move over there right quick. Whenever you get home, you get this kit, you're going to put your U-joint in to whatever yoke's on your transfer case. You can specify that off of whenever you order this thing online. It's 1350, 1410, or 1480. Right here we got a 1410. We went ahead and mocked this thing up, knowing that we needed the carrier bearing shaft, the carrier bearing housing, and then the yoke all slid together, and we tightened that nut down. That gives you a set distance here. And we went ahead and took and measured the tube out and cut it off the end and then slid it all together. What we were looking for is we wanted this mount right here that kind of ends up, we wanted it to end up on a cross member that we could weld to. Now we've actually went in here and shortened this mount down, and I've got the mock-up transmission out of the way so you can kind of show you what's going on. But kind of how you figure that out is you take the string again. Travis is going to hold this string line down here for us, and what I would like to see optimal would be from this yoke to that yoke, and this right here would be right in line with it. But you see I'm about split off, but honestly that's part of building a buggy. That's part of the world don't work exactly like you want it to every time. So, and that's really the reason we're using a carrier bearing, is to get around something that we can't move, and that's this cross member. We lined up this yoke and we shortened off our mount to be to where we're in a good safe distance away from this link bar, this link tab. We're a little bit out of line, but it's good enough to be okay. So we've got this clearance here. We shortened down that mount, then we bolted it all together, and then we tacked the mount that goes with the carrier bearing housing, we tacked that mount onto there. So then what we're going to look for is we're going to try to put this thing right dead in line, and we're going to use our string again. Travis is kind of holding that. I can get up here, kind of hold that thing, and we're in line this way. Now right there is what we're looking for now. Now we're looking to be in a good straight line that way. We can do pretty good with that. So I'm going to get Travis to run up here and tack this thing for me. And then I'll show you how to dial this thing in.
Different video,
Travis. Oh, that sounds better, Travis. What we've got now is everything's in there. We're working off machine faces, but now everybody's question is, like, how do you make sure that this thing's running true? And the answer is, it's pretty easy. Go get you a dial indicator with a base. These things aren't very expensive. If you're going to be working in the garage, setting up ring and pinions, anything, you need one of these. So go invest a little money and buy one. What you do is attach this thing right to the chassis. Somehow, wherever it's going to go. I need to get it where you guys can see the dial though.
I had it on the cross member there.
Right here?
Yeah.
But is it, it ain't stable right there, is it? Let's see here. All right, now we're in business. Screw this out. Screw this around. All right, we're gonna get this thing right here on this end. Dollar around at on zero. And now as I spin that, low end there will be right at zero. And I'm going to 10. Back to zero. So now what I'm gonna do is just take a hammer. I'm gonna tap this thing. You know, get my spend a little bit of time, and it takes a little bit of time. It's very aggravating. But with a little bit of time and patience, you can take this thing and you dial it in to about 7th out or less of run out. You can even, whenever you kind of practice with it, you can even use the heat cycles or whatever else to make sure that it, you can kind of draw the tubing either way with that as well. So then you make the whole shaft before you ever weld the mount onto your carrier bearing housing. So you've got your drive shaft dialed in, it's all burned together, you put it back in here, then you bolt up this mount and you make sure everything works right. Then you're going to pull the housing out. This tab here will be tack welded to your mount in the correct orientation. Then you're going to take this carrier bearing housing apart. Actually, take two snap rings out and press these bearings out. Then weld this assembly up and let it cool all the way down. Then press the bearings back in there. When you press those bearings back in there, take and spin your housing. Want to make sure that it spins really nice after it's welded. If it's not, if it's got a little clunk to it, take and just sand in the inside of that out a little bit with some sandpaper or a little file or something, and get those bearings to where they spin really free. You don't want any heat affecting those bearings, that heat working. So then after that piece is welded onto it, then you bolt it all back in there, and then you can final weld the mount to the chassis. So you've built a drive shaft and you got it all welded up. Then you welded the mount onto your housing. And after that was good and stable, then the last piece you put in was the mount into the chassis and you final welded it while letting the drive shaft hold everything in place. And that's how you get everything set up. That's the process of going through the deal and everything lines up good and in straight and in line. So, to kind of help you guys out, a lot of guys are using these carrier bearings. We sell a lot of them. I like to sell a lot more of them, but it'll help you out with lining it up. And this right here works with a drive shaft anywhere. It doesn't matter. It doesn't just work with this carrier bearing. You can set up and run a drive shaft true as long as you've got two points to clamp it in, the rear end and the whatever works with it. So use it. We'll catch you next time.